Before we move further with the subject, we need to understand what different types of forces act on a body and how do they affect the condition of the body. Let us consider them one by one. The very first type of force is everyone's favorite, the force due to gravitation. Every object with a mass will have a force from Earth pulling it towards itself. So a gravitational force is completely dependent on mass of the object, meaning a heavier object will experience a higher force as compared to the lighter object. This force will be directed towards the center of the planet, or to make it easier, let us say in a downward direction. Force due to resistance of air. This force can be experienced only by a moving object and acts in the opposite direction of the motion. As we do not concern ourselves with the very high speed in basic mechanics, this force experienced will be very small and hence it is often neglected. A normal reaction force. This force is based on Newton's third law of motion, stating that every action has an equal and opposite reaction. All the surfaces or bodies will apply a force which will be equal to the active force and will be directed into the opposite direction as the force. This reaction force is perpendicular to the surface at the contact to a considered body, hence the name. Frictional force. A frictional force is also a type of reaction force and is also directed in opposite direction, which prevents the body to be set in the state of motion. So, the next time you push a body and it doesn't move, it would mostly be because of the frictional force acting between the body and the surface. Alternatively, it also prevents the body from slipping. Tension force. This type of force would exist whenever the body is attached to a string or a cable. As you always see, some mass hanging from the string tends to pull the string and apply the tensile force on the string, trying to increase its length. This string would in return pull the body, passing this tensile force within itself onto the object. Hence, whenever a string or a cable is attached, the force will always act along the string and in the direction away from the body, indicating a tension. A spring has a tendency to return back to its original equilibrium position. Hence, so in a case of a compressed spring, it will tend to push the object away from itself to get back to its mean position. Zero force when the spring is uncompressed or it is in mean position. But when spring is stretched from its mean position, spring will pull the body back towards itself. Both these forces will be along the axis of the spring and directly proportional to the distance from its original position.